In this lesson, we explore the highly infectious world of the EB virus, which, when transmitted oropharynxally from a donor's mouth to a recipient's pharynx, leads to the dreaded condition known within the medical conspiracy as mononucleosis. To the ignorant, that's mono. An unusually slippery parasite, the EB or Epstein-Barnes virus is totally without prejudice. It couldn't care less whose stomatium its mega-metamorphic parasitic body invades. As the EB virus might say, they're all pink on the inside. It leaps from one glossal cavity to another, oblivious to the havoc it leaves behind. This indiscriminate contagion's favorite time for ravaging pharynxes is in the late fall or early spring. Its preferred environment is the labia and glossus of young humans, particularly those who indulge in excessive gropigatory oscillating, or kissing as the layman would call it. But what are the signs of mono? First of all, you're so tired you can barely lift your pedal extremities. Now check your neck for pharyngitis, or sore throat. Next, inspect all lymph glands for signs of lymphadenopathy, then quickly look for atypical lymphocytes. If you find you've got all five symptoms, you should alert all your comrades in promiscuity, because they've probably been infected too. But don't worry, it may not be too late. Normally, mononucleosis is easy enough to cure, and your friends can help. How? We'll find out in part two of Endangered Diseases.